Yeah, hello, good morning. So this is Neeraj. So as per discussion, so I have to give you some demo class for LiDAR classification. So first of all, so this is the airborne LiDAR data. So this is some sample data we have done. So now currently we are doing some wave temperatures also. Okay. So this is the airborne LiDAR data. Okay. So in this airborne LiDAR, so first of all, I have to explain what are the main contents we have to training in my session. So this is the LiDAR. LiDAR we have two modules are there. Okay, airborne LiDAR and also mobile LiDAR. So we have to complete just these two modules. Okay, but mostly we have to just mostly every company will depends on the airborne LiDAR projects. Why? Because the airborne LiDAR projects are very very continuous projects and mobile LiDAR also, but not continuous. It is simultaneous. It will come. So. So if I'm in this airborne and also mobile LiDAR, we have to say, what are the tasks we have to cover. So the classification, that means the data fusion, that means the future extraction. Okay. So we need to go, first of all, so first is our task is data identification and also data selection. That means we have to use some process to select any area and also data classification. That means modification. And after the second, so this is the first task of the production, and the second task is the ground reading. Grounded is nothing but a bare earth classification. Okay, we call it as a bare earth classification also. And after that, water body. Water body nothing but hydro classification. And after, so from all these parts also from the production task we have covered from the practical session. And also after that, not only production part, just okay, we have to cover the QC and QA, how to check the file in QC, QA, and output and output generation. And also including we have covered some of the concepts like contours and also brake lines. So we have to cover all these concepts including this. Okay. So first of all, I have to show the data for how to do the classification of this data. First of all, we have to use, so this is the, so we call it as a plan view. So we have to move the data from like this. Wherever you want to move, you can move, and we can and just zoom in from any area, and just go to view display mode, and we have to put normal all points apply, and view to also we can put normal all points apply. So this is the normal procedure. We have to whenever you want to start the modification of laser data, first of all you need to do some settings. So this, okay, first of all, okay, you can put some shading. So, see now this data is very, very clearly visible, right? See if we zoom in any area, some like particular area. So we have some tools out there. And also we are using some function keys. Okay, we are using the function keys, but actually here we are not setting any function keys. Okay, we have to create any function keys like and of course empty is not there, so F2 we can create the draw vertical section. So okay, I have created only from these two. We have created many more, but I have created only from these two. So if we select F1 means, see if we select the function is, that means the keyboard function is F1 to F10 is there, F1 to F10 options is there. So we need to select the function keys of F1 F2 like this. So I have to select F1 is pan view, that means moving the data, and F2, if you select F2 means it is automatically changed. So first of all, I'm explaining the software. So we are using the software as a MicroStation V8. Okay, V8 nothing but not a version. Okay, V8 nothing but we have 8 windows, 8 views. See here, the below V1, V2, V3, V4 up to V8. So we have to use for, but we have V8 means we have. Okay, we are not using up to 8 views, we are using only 1 and 2 views. But if we have any attached, if we have any image, okay, we have any doubt in your laser data, then only you can attach the raster image. So then only we can use the raster, just then only we can use the image 3 also. Okay, that means the Windows 3 also. Okay, so first of all, I need to select some data. So by using cross section, apply to V2. Why? Because this is a V2, this is a V1. So what is a draw section? Draw section means, so first of all, okay, whenever you select any top view of laser data, then it can display as a front view. See, it is a vehicle. See, it is displayed as a vehicle, right? See, See, and also it is a base station. See, and now this is a lower station. See, this is a gross level. This is a vehicle. See, some of the vehicles are not classified properly. So I need to classify now. See, from all these are vehicles. Okay, now I have to classify. And also one more thing I want to discuss about this. The client given all the input files from every project, but except images, the client given the four files, the four input files. The first one is an index file. Index one nothing but a decision file, and that's a layers data, and that's a project file. Okay, it's a project file also. It's a project file and just etc file. Okay. So what is meant by this PTC file? That means the client given the number of classes. See the default ground, low vegetation, medium vegetation, high vegetation, middling, low point, and tower, water body, high points, ground and ground, ground class. So based on the requirement, the client given some of the classes. Understand? So okay, based on the requirement only we need to classify the laser data, right? So then how to do the classification? So we have some tools out there. See that means classify using brush, classify below line, and classify brush, classify fin strokes, lot of tools are there. Now I want to classify these tools. Okay. By using below line, we have to add some classes, low, medium, vegetation, to which class? This is a car class. See, okay, don't disturb the ground class whenever you wanted to modify any laser data. Don't disturb the other option. So that is the main theme in our LiDAR data classification. Understand? See, what happened here, actually I have added low vegetation, medium vegetation. First of all, do you know about the vegetation? Vegetation is vegetation nothing but trees, okay? Vegetation nothing but trees. So, but actually in our, generally we have only one tree is there, but actually the client divide into one tree into three types of trees. That is the low vegetation, medium vegetation, high vegetation. Understand? But actually what happened here, see, this is the low vegetation, this is the medium vegetation. How to identify this is the low and this is the medium vegetation? So in this, go to medium dialog box and click identify option and click these points. See, it will display the low vegetation and as if we click here, this is the medium vegetation. Okay, right. So like this only we can identify. Otherwise, if you go to the different classes, so the client given lot of classes. So ground is which class and low vegetation is which color and medium vegetation is which color. So we have to identify like this. Okay, we have to remember the colors of the classes. Okay, so that is very important. Why? Because that is important. Why? Because we have to identify the object, and also we have to modify the class, and also we have to modify the objects by using colors only. See, all these are vehicles. So then only we can classify like this. And also see what are and also what about these objects? And if you go to zoom out. And see, and also what about these objects by selecting F2? See, these are just lines, whites are there, supply, okay? So in this, I have to use the above line tool from, so there is a, this power line class is there, so we need to classify line, see? Okay, so what happened, okay? Whenever you classify it in V2, the data should be updated in only V1, okay? See, like this only we have to classify. And what about this, the cover? That is the transformer, and we can just move the data, and again you can take some cross section, and again you can classify the laser like this only we have. Okay, a lot of objects are there. Okay, we need to classify each and every object according to the client requirement. So this is the airborne data. Actually, this is not the mobile LiDAR data. This is the airborne LiDAR data. Okay, mobile LiDAR data is different. From later I will show you how to classify this data. And also see, this is the buildings. See, this is the building. See, this is the building. So building is misclassified with the green color. Green color nothing but a high vegetation. So green color is a high vegetation in this class. See, how to identify the green color high vegetation? So go to high vegetation, click it, then see it is a green color. So what is happened here? The object is a building, but actually what happened? So the building is misclassified with some of the high vegetation. So we need to reclassify entire shape of the whole building class. So by using above line, we can use So building. So we need a classware. See, whenever you classware this, now it is updating in view 1. See, just to move the data. See, it is updated in this part. Again we have to take some cross section, and also again. See, okay, this is the future extraction. So, okay, we have to classify like this. See, just to move the data above. Why? Because the building above we have some lines are applied. So like this only we have to classify. Okay. So like this only we have to classify each and every object separately. See, here also the vehicles are there. Vehicles. So if you take the cross section is correctly, then we can easily identify in view 2. Okay, if you take the cross section as wrongly, means okay, we cannot identify object, then only we cannot modify the laser data. Understand? So that is the most important. So now what is happening? This is a vehicle actually. But vehicle actually, okay, how many classes are added in vehicle? The building is red color, low, medium vegetation. So I need to use the below line. And also I need to select the one more class and click OK. So these are vehicles are classified properly, right? So like this. Okay. So this is one of a demo class. I just explained one for something. Why? Because Collider have lot of concepts are there, but actually I don't want to explain all this one. Why? Because what is the main theme? I am just explaining. Okay. See, like this only we have to classify the laser data. We have a lot of, see, this is the trees. Okay. See, we have trees are there, but actually trees we did. Trees are very clear. Why? Because we don't need to, modify any trees. Why? Because the trees are very good. Why? Because the trees are already classified. See, if you go to view medium dialog box, I told you very clearly that the trees are divided into three types of vegetation. That is the low vegetation, medium and high vegetation. So no need to classify. Why? Because this is already in low vegetation, medium vegetation and also high vegetation. So no need to classify the trees. But actually whenever you wanted to classify the trees, means suppose if any trees, the building points are misclassified in trees. Okay? Sometimes the building points are misclassified. So this is a blunder mistake. Actually this object is a trace, but actually we don't. But object is trace. Okay. But actually what has happened? The building points are misclassified into trees. Misclassified vegetation, high vegetation. So from this time we can use one more tool. From this is a class of fence tool. From any class to high vegetation you can put. And also you can classify like this also, no problem. Click inside. See, now what has happened? Now entire the object is misclassified into vegetation. So like this only. See, this is the lot of tools are there. Classifies in brush, class of paints, class of class of above and class of below. So we have lot of tools are there. So then only we can classify by using all the tools we can classify each and every data. Okay. Depends on the situation, we can use the class of paints, above line, below line, brush tools, lot of. Okay. So like this only we have to, first of all, in the slider data classification, so before modify the data, first of all we need to identify the data. Identification is very very important. Why? Because without identification we cannot do any modification. Understand? So after identification, the data selection. So the data selection nothing but a data draw. That will be draw section. Okay? Nothing but a draw section. See how to take the draw section. Okay, how to take the draw sections are very very important. So we have two types of draw sections. So this is the vertical draw section, the straight, okay, and also this is the horizontal draw section. Understand? Then how to identify? How to take the draw section means, suppose, see, if I am taking this building. So, okay, if you take this is the horizontal draw section, that means the building is very clear. Otherwise, if you take this like this vertical, means it is very clumsy. Okay, we cannot identify properly. So the from edges it is from a horizontal, from this edge is vertical. So we can take as a proper way draw section, then only we can classify. See, now we can use the above line to building. See, it is very so like this only we can classify. Understand? See the view one is data updating. See. And also we can take like this. Again we can use the below, sorry, above line. Like this. Okay. And also. Then now see what will happen. I told you very clearly. So this is the building. This is, so up to this part is the building, right? No problem. But here what happened? The building points are misclassified at the highway station. So then you can use the other tool. So like a brush tool. Okay, we can put the building to highway station, and also you can use a brush test. Say 30, and then we can modify like this. See? Understand? Like this only we can modify. Okay? So this is very, very important. Why? Because the building points are only in building class only. Sorry, building object only. No need to misclass with any other object. Understand? You can use the brush tool like this. Okay? So like this only we have classification. So the classification is very, very important. After the classification, we have one more important main task is the ground dating. So the ground dating, that means the variant classification. So if you take the raw, so if you take like this means, see nothing we can identify. So if you take raw section like this, nothing we can identify. If you take very smooth, if you take proper image, it is very clearly visible. So the raw section is very identification, and also after the raw section is very, very important. Why? Because without If you take the wrong draw section means what will happen? Okay, you are doing wrong modification. Understand? So the draw section is very, very important. See, so we have to take some draw section like this, and also we have classify entire building. Okay? See, the building is updated like this. Understand? So like this only we have to classify each and every object according to the client requirement. Okay, so based on the project, just based on the project specification only we can do the modification, and this is the first task of the production part. So